Ladies and gentlemen, we present Cooper. And among those appearing in tonight's show are Michael Robbins. And special guest stars, Reflections. Ladies and gentlemen, meet the star of our show. Here he is, Tommy Cooper.
Thank you.
Out of there, should you? Oh, I always say a friend in need is a pest. Get rid of him. And if at first you don't succeed, forget it. Here's a little trick I'd like to show you now. It's a very famous egg bag trick. Now, this trick starts very slowly, and it gradually peters out. Oh, dear, oh, dear. Very famous egg bag trick. Do you know... Look, I'm leaking. I was walking along the street the other day. They all say that, don't they? I was walking along the street the other day, it's different, and there was a little fence there, so I said to myself, I'll look over there. I didn't have to, you know, but I just thought to myself, I will. So I looked over it like that. And there was a little chicken there, a little roll on in red. And he didn't notice me for a minute. And then he must have sensed I was there. Because he turned around and he looked at me like that. And I looked at him, and he was looking at me like that, and I looked at him, and then he went, oh, duck, duck, duck. So I went, oh, duck, duck, duck. And he went, oh, duck, 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 duck. And a policeman came along and arrested us for using foul language. Yes. Yes, sir. Sorry. Very famous egg bag trick. Watch very, very closely. This egg will vanish in front of your very eyes, and you won't have the slightest clue where it's gone. What am I looking up there? There's nobody up there. What am I looking up there? What? Look, it's gone! And you don't know where it is, dear. Where? And we are now. Another one? No, look at that there. This one? How's that? Hi, how's that? Uh-huh. Thank you. And you put your hand in this other bag and you're bringing the egg out to thunderous applause. It's not my night, is it? I've always been unlucky. Even when I was a little boy, I was unlucky. I had a rocket horse once and it died. I said to the doctor, I said, it hurts me when I do that. He said, well, don't do it. Oh, look at this one. Water from India. Well, it's been a very long, hot summer. Are you sure you would like some tea? It's very hot. There's a guardsman on sentry, you see, but he was on guard duty. And it's about 4 o'clock in the morning, it's very dark. And he's got the rifle there. And he's standing about 4 o'clock in the morning, very dark. And he falls asleep. Now, that's a crime, isn't it? I mean, they can put him aside for that. Straight away. So he's standing there asleep like that. Not like that, like that. Just standing there. And all of a sudden, the sergeant major comes around with the only officer. Marshal like that. And now he's standing right in front of him. And there he is asleep. And there's a sergeant major like that. Then all of a sudden, he just opens his eyes just a little bit like that. Not much, just a little bit like that. And he can see him standing there, you see? So he's got to think quick now, hasn't he? Yeah, it's got, otherwise he's got to be inside. So he stands like that for a few minutes. And he opens his eyes, he says, amen. Thank you.
That you've heard every single story about World War II, but let me tell you, this is not so. There's one experience that every soldier has undergone, and that's when he's been asked to fight not the enemy, but in the camp boxing tournament, and we do mean the camp boxing tournament. This, ladies and gentlemen, is a story of World War II of pure cowardice.
Come. We're only 5 minutes in the heavyweight bout. All right, sit down.
What's it like out there, then?
I beg your pardon?
Oh, you must have been in a fight. I've never seen a face bashed about so much in all my life. Dreadful.
I haven't fought yet.
Oh, really?
I'm fighting you.
Oh?
Have you had the gloves on before?
Yes, when I was 10 years old.
You've been fighting since you were 10?
No! My mother made me wear my boxing gloves so I wouldn't bite my fingernails. You're going to bash the hell out of me, aren't you? I know you're right. You're going to show me up in front of the officers out there, I know. There's always one.
I don't want to touch you. I mean, I think it's a dead liberty getting two complete strangers to bash hell out of each other just to satisfy some bloodthirsty CO. I'm going to put in a complaint about it.
Really?
I have never boxed before in my life. I don't want to get hurt. I mean, can't we work something out? Fake it.
I'm going to bash the hell out of you.
No, please don't be like that. Look, I didn't want to get into this in the first place. I'm engaged to be married, and after all, I am officer material.
Well, I don't care. Ah! It was a very good idea of yours. Well, fake it.
All right, then, how are we going to go about it?
Well... I think we'll start off... We'll start off with a...
Pardon?
Well, they all do that, don't they? You see them all do that in a boxing ring. They go... It looks good, doesn't it? And it sounds good.
Yes!
It's good, I think so. It's a good idea.
Yeah, frankly good idea.
It's a good idea, right?
Frankly good idea.
Is he with you?
Come on, let's try it.
All right, well, now we're friends, yes.
Yes.
All right.
Right
you are.
What is that? Radio. Ready. You're ready.
Should have went to Clang then.
What a high rate! What do you think?
I think you're winning by 2-1.
God, this is getting us nowhere.
I don't know about that. Oh, God! I don't know. I think with one's good, I could be lying on the floor.
Yeah, but, big cream puff.
But look, at some point, we have got to hit each other. Right? I mean, how hard are we going to hit each other?
Well. It's very hard to say about that. Let me just try a little tap on your shoulder.
Right. Oh. Yeah, well, not too bad. Now it's my turn.
No.
Well, I've got to hit you.
No, we don't have to prove that now. Because we know we don't have to prove it anymore, do we? We don't, do we?
Yeah, big cream puff.
What does he mean, cream puff? Now look, I have got it. I have got to hit you, otherwise I won't know whether I'm going to hurt you when we've got the actual thing, am I?
Right. Well, all right, then. Well, just a little one, then.
Right.
Not like you did through that locker.
No, right. Where do you want it?
Have it there. It's the only test of pain, isn't it?
Oh, right. How's that?
Very much. I like that very much. From now on, keep them down there. Down there all the time.
I can't hit you down there while we're fighting.
Well, I can walk around the ring like that, can't I?
Don't be so stupid. I mean, that's hitting below the belt.
Well, I won't wear a belt.
That's got nothing to do with it, you stupid great fool.
What is... fool? That hurt me, that did. Listen. Do you want to fight?
I want to fight, man.
You want to fight?
You want to fight?
Yeah, I want to
fight.
I
want to fight.
I want to fight.
You want to fight?
I want to fight. I want to fight. I don't want to fight.
No, I don't
fight.
Yeah, big cream puff.
Oh, come on, let's try again. Something to work out. Come on, come on, on your feet. On your feet, right?
Go for his left eye, Jonesy. Split it wide open, there'll be blood everywhere. Now in for his guts, he'll go down like a pack of cards.
Ow!
In!
Ow! Ow! Oh, just a minute.
What?
Can I have a quiet word with you?
Yes.
Are you sure he's not with you?
Who?
Tarzan.
Oh, yes, he's my second.
Well, you should have stuck with the first. Tell him to keep out of this.
Yes, you're quite right. You're quite right. Cedric, will you kindly keep out of this? We're trying to work out something together here. Do you really think I could open up his left eye?
Of course you could. He'll go down like a pack of cards.
Ha-ha! Yes, I really think I could take him. Ha-ha!
No, just a minute. You're not going to believe him, are you? I thought you and I had agreement.
I'll tell Sergeant. I'll tell him you've both been trying to cook up a fake. You'll get shoved in jankers. You big cream puff.
I'm most awfully sorry. I got carried away. I'm terribly sorry. What are we going to do now?
Well, we can't fake it anymore, can we? He's going to tell the Sergeant otherwise, isn't he?
Right.
All right, over here, is it? I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to get a real sucker punch.
A pucker
sucker punch? No, not a pucker sucker. A sucker punch. Well, you know, a real punch.
Right. Yes.
See, we'll do a real sucker punch.
Yes.
And it'd be all over, wouldn't it?
You're quite right.
We'll
it's worth it for one punch.
Yes.
We'll try the sucker punch then. All right.
Welcome once again to Fez to Fez, an intense and searching interview with a great mind.
Look, before you go on, I'd like to tell you a little joke. See, I'll say, it won't go on, and you say, what won't go on?
I'm sorry, Tommy, but we do have to press on with the interview.
Yeah, but it'll only take 5 seconds.
Nevertheless, I have a lot of very, very serious questions to ask you tonight. I want to ask you about your family, your views on marriage, and so on and so forth, and we haven't got the time. If you want to tell a joke, you save it till next time, right? I want to get on with the serious questions of this interview.
I could have done the joke 5 times. What, you've been talking?
Now, the first question is the obvious one. Do you have a family of your own?
Yes. A boy and a girl.
Ah. So, naturally, you have a wife.
Look, if you could tell a joke like that, why can't I tell my joke?
Do you believe in the sociological compatibility of marriage as an institution in the 20th century?
Look, that's all I said, it won't go on. That's all I say, it won't go on. And he says, what won't go on? It's all over like a flash, like a flash of light.
What's your view on the vexed question of relations within the family unit?
Well, I had a big aunt once, and she was, what's the word I'm looking for?
An eccentric.
No. What country?
Country? Chile? Romania? Chile, that's it. Your great aunt was Chile.
No, she wasn't, no. Slightly cold, but not Chile.
Finland.
Oh, just a minute, I've got to chuckle there.
Well, if it wasn't Chile, it could have been Finland or Austria or Brazil.
Brazil, that's it. Brazil. She was nuts.
What made you think she was nuts?
When she came back to this earth again, she'd come back as a chicken.
What's so funny?
Well, I ate her this morning.
That's it, I've had it. That's it, I have
smart, all right.
Had it. I don't know, I was warned not to do this interview in the first place.
See, that's all
I mean,
say,
slaving over the questions for hours and hours.
Similar to that.
Trying to do a bit of research.
That's all you're going to say.
You give it sweat and blood, you come in here, what do you get?
Oh, it's so similar.
Load of rubbish.
Like a fact of life, I mean, I understand it.
I'll stick to playing records.
I mean, I could have done it about half an hour ago. It just won't go on, it won't go on. Well, he's just dragging it out. He keeps talking to me. It's a whole load of rubbish he keeps talking to me about. I said, who's going to say it? I've got to say it, not him. It won't go on. He said, what won't go on? That's it.
Sick of
it. I mean, if this show doesn't get along, they're going to take it off. That's it, they're going to take it off. I mean that. It just won't go on. It won't go on.
All right, what won't?
This shirt, I keep telling you, it won't go on. Hey, look at that.
Well, in that case, I think we better say good night.
Yes. Good night.
Good night.